How to follow a line using LEGO Robot's Inventor 51515 set. These and other tutorials can be found in a free booklet available for download from www.drg2.com from Dr. Graeme. We will start up the code the same way as we have done with our previous line following tutorial. Find the set movement motors to A and B command and add that to our code. TAS1's motors are connected to slots E and F, so change the command to E and F. Next, find a pink set movement speed to 50% command and add it to our program. Change the speed to 30%, which should be a good speed for testing our line following code. Find a yellow forever command and add it to our program. Next, find a yellow if-then-else command and add that as well. In the second method of line following, we use the reflected light that TAS1's colour sensor sees. Connect TAS1 to our computer. I'm using a USB cable to connect TAS1 to my computer. To find out what TAS1's colour sensor sees, we first click on the hub connection icon at the top right of our screen. We see an image of our LEGO computer hub. Connected to slot C, you will see the color sensor image. Click on it, then click on reflect. You will now see a number below the color sensor image. This number, which varies from 0 to 100, is a measure of the reflected light as seen by the color sensor. But how do we use this to follow a line? Suppose we are following a black line. Move TAS1's colour sensor over the black line. In my case, the reading hovers around about 24%. If I move TAS1's colour sensor so that it is above the non-black area alongside the line, which is usually white but it can also be a colour, we get a reading that hovers around 92%. Your readings will be different because the reading partly depends on the level of background light, which is different from room to room. Now you add these numbers together and divide by 2. In my case, it'll be 24 plus 92 divided by 2 equals 116 divided by 2 equals 58. Write this answer down. We will use it later. Click on the cross to go back to the editor. Find the green less than command. Choose this and move it into the slot in the yellow if then command. Change the 100 to the number you have written down. In my case, this is 58. Next, find the blue A reflected light command. Place it in the left slot of the green command. Because TAS1's light sensor is in slot C, change the commands A to C. Next, we need a new movement command. To show this, we go to the bottom left of the screen and click on the Show Block Extensions icon. Find the More Movement image and click on Add. We've already added them, so in this example, you will not see the Add button, but it will look like these other Add buttons. Go down to the bottom of your menu items on the left of the screen, and you'll find there are 9 more movement commands. Click on the Start Moving at 50% Speed command, and move it into the first vacant slot of your code. Then move the same command into the second vacant spot of your code. Now, if TAS1's colour sensor sees a reflected light of less than 58, the colour sensor will be over the black line. To follow the right-hand edge of the line, we need TAS1 to turn right, or clockwise when seen from above, which means the speed of TAS1's motor connected to the E slot on the left of the hub has to have a high value, and TAS1's motor connected to the F slot on the right side of the hub has to have a lower value. In this case, we will choose 40 for the E motor and 30 for the F motor. If the reflected light is greater than 58, TAS1's colour sensor will be on the non-black edge of the line. So we need TAS1 to turn left, anti-clockwise when seen from above, back towards the black line. To do this, we will choose a speed of 30 for the left-hand E motor and 40 for the right-hand F motor. This completes our code, and let us see how TAS1 runs on a straight line. Works beautifully. However, if we put TAS1 on a curve, it doesn't work, it leaves the line. If we change the values to 40 and 20, as shown here, and we try it again, then we find it follows the curve. However, if we try a sharper curve, we need to change it to 50 and minus 20 to get around. You'll notice it jigs and jags a lot more. We can use the same technique to follow the edge of coloured lines. In this case, the reflected light reading from TAS1's colour sensor from the green line is 25. The reflected light reading from TAS1's colour sensor for the blue background is 43. And just as before, we take the 25, add the 43, divided by 2, which equals 68, divided by 2, which equals 34. We use that 34 in our if-then code statement, so that when TAS1 sees a colour reading less than 34, it will assume it is over the green line and needs to turn towards the blue. When TAS1 sees a colour sensor reading greater than 34, it will be over the blue and needs to turn towards the green line. We can use the same motor values of 40 and 30 as we did previously for the straight line run, and it will run like this. Which is a good run. That's the end of the code in this tutorial, but a couple of words of warning. The colour sensor readings that I used in this tutorial will be very unlikely to work in your robot because the light conditions in the room and the type of surface that your robot is running over will be different. But if you take the sensor readings just as we've shown you in this tutorial, your robot should be able to follow a line well. It's also worth noting that while TAS1 is a good shape for a starter robot, it's not a good shape for a line follower robot. You will be able to make a line follower robot which will be much better than TAS1. So, enjoy making your robots. Please click on the subscribe and like buttons, it makes us feel appreciated. Remember, you can download a free PDF e-booklet that contains this and other tutorials, plus a background. And enjoy your robotics.